Brexit has raised the question of the UK reclaiming its fishing waters, but disputes over fisheries have been going on for decades. In fact, France even sent a warship to the UK after a fishing dispute escalated in 1972. By UN convention, the UK has an area of fishing waters stretching up to 200 miles away from its shores. However, under the Common Fisheries Policy (CFP) launched in 1983, all EU countries have access to everyone else's waters. Currently, over 60% of the fish caught in UK waters are caught by boats from overseas. Boris Johnson has promised to take back UK waters for British fishermen, and while this would be a huge boost of the industry, it could mean a return to the endless. For example, in the 60s and 70s, relations between the UK and France were tested by repeated illegal fishing in UK waters by French vessels. Between 1964 and 1972, 37 French fishing vessels were detained and brought into UK ports, 36 of whom were charged and convicted of illegal fishing in British waters. In 1972, Edward Heath's government had just agreed for the UK to enter the EEC, but tensions over fishing had reached boiling point. Documents unearthed in the National Archives by Express.co.uk reveal how one particular incident blew up. It all came to a head when British fisheries protection vessel HMS Kellington arrested a French trawler called Athos for illegally fishing in British waters on March 20. The next day, the French warship L'Agile descended on the port of Fishguard, Wales, without giving any prior warning to the UK government or local naval commander. The trawler had requested French naval officers to come as witnesses to give evidence on their behalf. The ship, L'Agile, which should have informed the local naval authorities of its intention straight away, instead arrived unannounced as a surprise to not only the local naval commander, but the Ministry of Defence (MOD) and the Foreign and Commonwealth Office (FCO). Labour MP George Cunningham asked Peter Kirk, Undersecretary of State for the Navy, whether he would stand for this behaviour. He asked, "Is it not a highly unusual practice for a foreign state to send one of its warships into a British port following the arrest of a merchant vessel and the trial of its captain in the British port? Has the Undersecretary observed that the captain of the French ship said that, though unusual, this practice might have to become normal? Will he arrange with the Foreign Office that the French government is told that whether it becomes normal will be the decision of the British government, not of the French government?" Mr. Kirk admitted that it was unusual for the French Navy to arrive unannounced on the UK shore. He replied, "The drill for fishery protection vessels like L'Agile is for us to be given an outline program in advance. We are supposed to be given 24 hours notice of a call. This call was rather..."